All right, so let us jump into number four. Page 76, chapter three, computing with numbers. Programming exercises. Write a program that determines the distance to a lightning strike based on the time elapsed between the flash and the sound of thunder. The speed of sound is approximately 1100 feet per second. And 1 mile is 5280 All right, if we remember that from math days, we're going to call this thunder. So our top thunder dot pi. This program calculates how far lightning is. Who observes the lightning strike? And here's the thunderclap. Important. No. We just call it info. Speed of sound is 100 feet per second. Check it out. Think we save this one. Save this one. So up here, you can see. Okay. So we're gonna do. Determines the distance to a lightning strike. So let's just. This one's write the exact phrase that the question asks. Distance in miles. A lightning strike. It doesn't say specifically what they want, but we can put it in miles. So, and quote here. If you want to print, user input is going to be this is going to be float. It might be. So I might get cute and write a float. So how much time elapsed between the flash and the sound of thunder? So that's going to be input. distance. So the distance is going to be what? Let's check it out. It's going to be, well, let's say it's 5 seconds. You're looking at 5 seconds. So it's going to be 1,100 feet times the what's this going to be? Time. Times time. So that's the number of feet. So 5,500 feet. Right? 5,500 feet. And then divide that by 5,280. And then let's just print the distance. Let's try it. Okay. Let's check this out. Let's open. So this is going to be 100. All right, here we go. Let's just see all my folders on my desktop. Got a lot on there. I got to clean that stuff up. All right, so here we go. So, okay, let's do two parentheses. I think it looks okay. This should be good. Let's run it. What's great about Python is we don't have to declare the variable type, but I think we might. So distance is, do we have to do it? Do we have to float it? I think so. I think we do. I think here we do, because we've got to float. That's going to be time. It's invalid syntax. So let's try D. Maybe it's because that's a keyword. Oh, I know. It's not a keyword. It's a lot of times it's from before. That happens to me all the time when I make mistakes. There's just a parenthesis. So let's try to not do that. Let's try to just do 1100. Times time slash 5,280. Okay, let's save that. And then print distance, and let's save that. I don't think distance. I didn't think distance was a keyword. A lot of times it's just that. Okay, so let's say 5. Oh. For int and none type. So this has got to be float. And then let's save that and run it. 4 seconds. Keep getting an error. 1,100 times time slash 5,280. Oh, here's what it is. So we're not going to print it. Oh, we are going to print it, right? We're going to print No, I'm not going to print. That's why. It's just going to be float input. I don't know why I wrote print. That's an error. Okay, so I don't think we need float, but we'll just leave it. We'll see if it, we shouldn't get punished for being a little redundant. Okay, so 1.04. Does that make sense? Well, let's do some math. All right, so let's look at our comments. So we're gonna do 5 times 1100, and then there it is. It's 1.04 miles. So now let's fix this in terms of miles. Well, that's something that we saw earlier. Remember, it was like comma 2, and we're rounding it all out, and let's try it. I think I can remember it. I like to try to remember before I look stuff up. So let's do round. Let's do math dot round. Actually, we're just gonna do this, and then we're gonna print math dot round, which I think applies the method round, the module math. And then distance, and then I think it's 2, and then comma miles. I think that should work. Let's try it. I thought it's pretty aggressive. It's kind of amazing sometimes. Nope. Okay, so math is, so it has no attribute round. I thought it did though. It is just round. Let's try it. So this is not going to be up there. Yeah, that's going to be distance, comma 2. So that here, that second 2 is how many spaces to the right of our parenthesis. Yeah, I think that that's fine. I think that that's good. I don't think we need a parenthesis after that parenthesis where the cursor is. Let's try. Right. Yeah, nice. I think it's redundant. I think we put that. It's kind of redundant because then you gotta put it there because you gotta. It's pretty obvious. Do we need to import math? Let's try. I'm not sure. We didn't use it as a method. It wasn't like a math module method. Yeah, it's part of Python. We don't need. Anyways, hopefully this helps. Thunder.py. One more thing I want to write is I want to write how much time lapsed in seconds, right? So then let's try it one more time, and we'll try it like a bunch of times, but so let's see, 39 seconds, 8 miles, does that seem right? 39 times 1100 is about 40 times 1,000, which is 40,000. 40,000 divided by 5,000 is 40 divided by 5. 40 divided by 5 is about 8. All right, I think we're good to go. Thanks a lot, guys. See you guys. Hopefully see you guys on the next one. This was number four, page 76, Programming Exercises, Chapter 3. Thank you very much.